These movie parodies led us on a hilarious trip down memory lane.
I am your father's, brother's, nephew's, cousin's former roommate.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 spoof scenes in movies.
Votre chance.
For this list, we're focusing on movie scenes that parody other movie scenes. Funny or serious, doesn't matter, as long as one film references another film. Number 10, Disco Dancing from Saturday Night Fever, Airplane. Sure, it may be about nothing more than a group of quirky airport employees, but Airplane is one of the greatest and most quotable satirical comedies ever. Even though it mostly parodies the disaster film genre overall, the best spoof in Airplane is pretty much the shot-for-shot remake of a famous moment in Saturday Night Fever. In the scene, the main protagonist, Ted Stryker, is telling the story of how he met his one true love, Elaine, and it involves a bar, the Bee Gees, and a rather silly version of a disco dance number originally performed by John Travolta. From the choreography to the famous singers, Airplane's level of comedy stays sky-high throughout, especially in this scene.
I had to ask the guy next to me to pinch me to make sure I wasn't dreaming.
Number 9, Staircase Shootout from The Untouchables and Battleship Potemkin. Naked Gun 33 and a third, The Final Insult.
Oh my god, look! It's disgruntled postal workers!
It may be the lowest grossing Naked Gun film, but 33 and a third still brings the spoofs. In fact, the film's opening is a parody of a parody, or rather, an homage. It recreates a famous scene from 1987's The Untouchables, which in turn recreates the famous Odessa Steps sequence from 1925's Battleship Potemkin. Frank Drebin is waiting for something when he decides to help a woman with a baby carriage up many, many stairs, kind of like Kevin Costner. But once the mobsters show up, Drebin starts a wild shootout that involves multiple falling strollers, President Clinton, the Pope, a suicide bomber, mass murdering mailmen, and awkwardly, O.J. Simpson before the infamous murder. As if that weren't funny enough, it's all a dream.
Frank! Are you all right?
I'm soaking wet.
I'll get the talcum powder.
Number 8, the T-Rex reveal from Jurassic Park, Wayne's World 2.
So that would put us...
Garth! Wait a minute.
Whether he's crashing through weddings like Dustin Hoffman in The Graduate or pulling off the Thelma and Louise ending, Mike Myers is clearly a movie buff. But for our money, the best spoof scene in Wayne's World 2 is his parody of Jurassic Park, which was released a mere 6 months before this sequel.
Listen.
Wayne and Garth are trying to plan a music festival called Waynestock, and they're scouting the location on a rainy day. But all of a sudden, they encounter a T-Rex paying homage to an iconic shot in the Steven Spielberg film. How did Wayne and Garth end up in Jurassic Park, you may be asking? We are not worthy of the answer. Number 7, Always Been Here from The Shining, Hot Fuzz.
I was hoping to check in.
Check in? But you've always been here.
Like many movies on this list, this badass British police comedy is a satire of an entire genre's worth of films, but the scene we've selected parodies something entirely different. Simon Pegg and Nick Frost are two police officers trying to solve a murder in a quaint little village. When Pegg's character, Nicholas Angel, is checking into his hotel, he's met with a line of dialogue eerily reminiscent of The Shining.
You've always been the caretaker.
However, whereas Jack Torrance's hotel chat is with a ghost, Sergeant Angel is just trying to get to his room. Fortunately, the hotel Angel checks into isn't haunted, and the conversation is followed by a slew of hilarious misunderstandings involving a crossword puzzle.
I'm Joyce Cooper. I trust you had a pleasant trip. Fascist.
I beg your pardon?
System of government characterized by extreme dictatorship. Seven across.
Number 6, Head Spin from The Exorcist, Toy Story.
It's busted.
Who are you calling busted, Buster? That's right. I'm talking to you, Sid Phillips.
Like any animated feature worth its salt, Pixar's breakout movie about the secret life of toys threw in enough jokes for the adults to keep parents entertained alongside with their kids. In an effort to teach budding psychopath Sid a lesson and save his buddy Buzz, Woody enlists the help of Sid's other victims to scare the bejesus out of the toy torturer. During the ambush, our favorite cowboy doll takes a page out of The Exorcist's book, spinning his head around a full 360 degrees, much like the possessed Reagan McNeil does in front of the two shaken priests.
Amen.
It might be a little heavy for a kid's movie, but nonetheless, the reference fits perfectly. That'll teach Sid to play nicer with his toys.
We toys can see everything.
So play nice.
Number 5, chest burster from Alien, Spaceballs.
Bring some water! Water my ass!
Following a Han Solo-like character and his half-man, half-dog sidekick as they travel the galaxy to defeat the evil Lord Dark Helmet and save a princess, this Mel Brooks space spoof tackles Star Wars, parodying everything from Imperial cruisers to near declarations of paternity. But alas, it's got a dead-on alien spoof we just can't forget.
Oh God!
In their travels, Captain Lone Star and Barf stop at a diner, where actor John Hurt also happens to be eating. What follows is a scene we'd swear we've seen somewhere before.
Oh no, not again.
Making this otherwise disgusting alien parody even funnier is the fact that the chestburster then performs a charming musical number, a la Michigan J. Frog. Say what you will, but that's adorable.
Hello my baby, hello my honey, hello my ragtime gal.
Number 4, fatherly reveal from The Empire Strikes Back. Austin Powers, the spy who shagged me.
Ow! You shot me, you a-hole!
One of the most hilarious spoof scenes in this satire of James Bond is actually another parody of Star Wars.
No, I am your father.
Austin and Dr. Evil have finally caught up with each other on the villain's moon base, when the good doctor makes a stunning reveal.
Austin? I am your father.
However, unlike The Empire Strikes Back, Dr. Evil is of course not Austin's father and admits how ridiculous his claim is.
No, not really. I can't back that up.
Hey, at least he was honest, right? What ups the funny factor of this scene even more is how out of nowhere it is. And luckily for Austin Powers fans, this spoof scene is one of many.
Fire the laser!
Number 3, bulletproof vest trick from A Fistful of Dollars, Back to the Future, Part 3. The third installment of the BTTF franchise follows Marty McFly and Doc Brown to 1885, where they can reference as many movies as they want and no one will know what they're talking about.
You talking to me?
In fact, while in the Old West, Marty goes by the name of Clint Eastwood.
What kind of stupid name is that?
And that piece of foreshadowing comes into play near the end of the film. Marty, or Clint, has agreed to face Mad Dog Tannen in a gunfight. But being from 1985, he has a century's worth of wisdom to help him out at the showdown. Marty taps into his film knowledge, copying the real Clint Eastwood's move in A Fistful of Dollars by taking a boilerplate and using it as a makeshift bulletproof vest. Bad ass. Number 2, garage door death from Scream, Scary Movie.
Oh my God, please don't. Please, I'm just a day player.
If you remember the 90s, you know that teen horror flicks made a big comeback during that decade, and with them they brought the inevitable spoofs. Scary Movie takes aim at many popular horror films, but the scene we've chosen to mock an iconic death from is 1996's Scream. A young partygoer is trapped in the garage by Ghostface. But where things diverge from the source material is when the girl tries to escape through the kitty flap in the garage door. This girl does not get her head crushed by the opening garage. No, due to her weight, she causes everything to collapse on top of her. Seeing Ghostface's reaction to the incident makes this moment comedic gold. Before we get to our number one spoof scene, here are a few honorable mentions.
Eyes closed.
Eyes closed.
Now you have to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do ya, punks?
You've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Number 1, Defoe Death from Platoon, Tropic Thunder.
When we get back to the world, I'm gonna finally teach you how to juggle.
Since this Ben Stiller joint is a satire of the film industry as a whole, it's littered with hysterical references to past films and actors.
Who left the fridge open?
But one of the most memorable spoof scenes comes at the beginning of the movie, when the actors are filming an intense and very expensive action sequence for their fictional film, also called Tropic Thunder. Stiller's character, Tug Speedman, is running out of the jungle, hands in the sky, as he's shot multiple times. This moment was, of course, originally made famous by Willem Dafoe in Oliver Stone's Platoon, and Stiller and company do it comedic justice. The scene is so overly dramatic, it's perfect.
I'm sorry, can we cut?
Do you agree with our list?
Yeah!
What's your favorite movie spoof scene?
You're still here?
For more satirical top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.
You're still here. It's over. Go home.